I think this is around about the time when they would tell you listen to this track, bitch.
And that's alright, but who are you? Just another nigga with a strap. It don't take rocket science to shoot. You don't know shit about getting bricks out. You probably still work true for true. You don't know shit about on your blood, cause you paid your bills with all that loot. How about your baby about to be born and him got Pampers wipes of food? How about your mama fucking your best friend and y'all both just finished school? But it's okay, she thinks it's cool. You're in her way, it's time you move. And you just paid all her damn bills, so you feel like a fool. So what do you suggest I do? You think you know?
Welcome,
you
got no clue, so please don't tell me. Welcome to AJ's Den. Let's get right on in. Yesterday was Fidel Castro laid to rest. Sterling's supposed to be laid to rest tomorrow. So I just really, and no one is not talking about Alva as well. It was an African-American man who was shot down in Houston, Texas, that was killed on Saturday. So it's like bite to bite, they are killing African-American people. And I asked this question on my, the first thing I have on there is saying, why is it that a lot of Caucasians, when a cop kill an African American, that they have to bring up genocide? Now listen, I am against genocide as well, but don't try to make an excuse for these cops that's taking my brothers and my sisters' lives. This is basically what they're trying to do. They're making an excuse, like saying, oh, it's okay because they killing each other as well. So let me go ahead and say, yeah, you killing each other. So why can't I kill each other? So you don't want accountability? Is this what a lot of Caucasians don't want to see? To see that these white cops that are killing my brothers and sisters, that you're making an excuse. So you're saying, well, they killing each other. So why can't I kill each other? Why can't I kill them? Well, you can't. And I'm against genocide myself. So why are you always bringing genocide up when a cop kill? I mean, you kill. I saw the statistics not too long ago. It was 132, I think. 132 African Americans have been killed by cops this year. And we still have more months to go. We still have more months to go. There's a problem. When a African Americans continue to get killed by cops, and not only that, they are not going to jail. There is no accountability. It's none of that. So we have a, let's back up. They're saying that we do not have a racial problem in America. You're a damn lie if you're saying that we don't have a racial problem in America. I was watching this on, Kelly had D.L. Hughley on. And matter of fact, let me go ahead and play that. Because I was like, girl, bye. I was like, girl, get your life. This woman, and I expect that from Fox. Fox is the most racist place that newscast information that you can ever look at. I expect that from Fox. I expect that from Kelly. And yeah, I'm calling the bitch by her first name. Because she don't even see racism that exists. Not only that it exists, she tried to get away from Fidel and Fidel Castro and went on Mike Brown. They always trying to get the bad person. They don't want to talk about the person who had no record. Fidel Castro was a supervisor. He was doing everything that you possibly, and it's a shame that you have to say that. He or she was doing everything that Americans want them to do. We're not your kids. And I have said this on several times. So many times. Listen, white people, Caucasians, we're not your kids to tell how we should act. Are you serious? That kills me. That really do. That you think we are your kids. No, we're not. But you try to make an excuse when a Caucasian killed an African American and that Caucasian is the cop. That's no excuse. We need to see that they are going to prison when they shoot somebody like Fidel Castro. Or when they shoot somebody like Sterling. Or when they shoot somebody like Mike Brown. Or when they shoot somebody like Tamir Rice. Or when they shoot somebody, when they shoot Alva. When they shoot Eric Garner. When they shoot these people. We need to see them being accountable for their actions. They can be cops. But have a reason when you kill somebody. You somehow, a Caucasian cop, and I have said it and said it several times, that you can keep your composure when it comes down to your own. And don't let me start saying names out, because I could say a lot of Caucasian names that charge at you with a gun and a knife. You ran away from them. You kept your composure and you didn't kill them. They are still alive today. Hell, I could give you an example. Back in the old days, Nikki Williams, who started, everybody know who Nikki Williams is, who actually started the Crips. Why is it? And he didn't kill anyone. They still to this day haven't proved that Nikki Williams killed anyone. Still to the day. Today, 2016. They couldn't prove nothing. They didn't prove nothing. But he was executed. And he turned his life around. And he wrote a book. But they still execute him. Charlie Manson, who you know is a white man, still alive to this day. And they know that he ordered killings. They know that he ordered killings. They know that he was in there. And it's crazy because he still have followers. Still have followers to the day, to this day. They know all this. The justice system, DOG, anybody in the White House know all this. Why is he still alive? This man getting 3 meals a day in a cot. Why? Because his life matter, regardless of what all the stuff that he have done and ordered to do. He's still alive because he's a Caucasian. That show how much our life mean. You can sit up here and not compare it. Compare it. Charles Manson ordered, and they knew that he ordered. Nikki Williams, who was the starter of the Crips, that nobody won't go back. Let's go back why the Crips got started. A lot of people don't know the details of why the Crips got started. So let's go back, because it all boils down to these Caucasians. The reason why Piru Bloods is Piru and the Crips got started is because it was a white gang. A white gang that was terrorizing the people in Compton. People don't know that. Read your book. They'll put up there the first game on the definition. They'll say the first game was the Crips and the Bloods. No, it wasn't. It was Caucasians. They was bullying the people who moved in Compton. Compton was, and people didn't know this. Excuse me. Compton was a well-off neighborhood that even President Reagan was raised up in. People don't know that either. It was a well-known neighborhood that a lot of white people was living in. And it became it was so segregated, they didn't want African-Americans to move in that neighborhood until it was passed in the Civil Rights Order. And once it passed, a lot of African-American family moved in Compton. Well, at that particular time, a lot of Caucasians did not want to accept that, so they became bullies. And if we want to really go all the way back, the first gang was when they got rid of the Native Americans off their own land. That was Caucasians. So don't tell me about the first gang was the Crips and the Bloods. But let's go back there. So when these Caucasians saw, excuse me, saw these African-Americans who moved in Compton, they stopped bullying them and they formed a gang. When these African-Americans, they was going on the other side to go to school, these Caucasians start telling them, you can't cross over to this certain street. This is our street, and we're going to stop you from crossing over. Read your history. Look it up. Everything I tell you, I ain't going to tell you a lot. Look it up. Look it up. See, they won't tell you the real games was them Caucasians they started. So, like we always do, listen, we always conquer it. You're gonna bully us, and you're gonna tell us, and you're gonna get somebody to beat us up. You're gonna get y'all guys to beat us up. So we're gonna form a game on your ass. You're gonna stop this. You're gonna stop beating our people. And that's what happened. And guess what? How you cops are doing us as African Americans, killing us? Keep it up. Keep doing what you're doing. The same as we accomplish and overpower as the Crips and the Bloods, that I do not condone this, their actions. That's what's going to happen. So keep doing what you're doing, and you're going to see some reactions that you're not going to like. People, they try to hide a lot of stuff that you thinking that these people don't do. They do some horrible thing. And I say these people, I'm talking about Caucasians. Caucasians try to hide the fact that they have done a lot to inform a lot of things. But we wind up conquering it. We wind up conquering everything what they start. See what I'm saying? And they don't like that. I was looking at a white supremacist, and he didn't consider himself a white supremacist. But it was on TV1, Roland Martin show. And he was like, I'm not a white supremacist. Duke is not a white supremacist. And such and such. And then Roland Martin said, well, why don't you consider yourself a white supremacist? Well, as he was talking, he was showing that he was a white supremacist. Because then he said, we're coming together. We love Trump. And we're glad that he's gone. I'm going to vote for him because we're basically losing our power. We're going to be the minorities. And I said this on my show before. This is why they're reacting the way they're acting, because they're scared to lose the power that they have right now. They do not want to lose that power. And that is their biggest problem right now with the... They're afraid that we might treat them the way they have treated us for a century of time. They don't want to share the power. They want to keep hold on that power. And that's basically what he was saying. And he's saying, any African-Americans, you see, the basically, these people who support Trump, and I said this before as well, that when they support Trump, they want to convince African-Americans that he's looking out for our own benefit. That's why he also denied the invitation from the NAACP. You notice he didn't go to the NAACP. He denied the invitation. He wasn't going to come. Of course, he doesn't care about people of color. But they're trying to get us as a people to vote for them, because he know he can't become president without our votes and Hispanic votes. So he will lie and say that, oh, I care about African Americans and African Americans care about me. You know what I'm saying? Where I'm going at? He's trying to get you a vote for him. But once he get in there, he wouldn't know you from Adam and Eve. Do you understand me? He's trying to take America back in the 60s. That white fountain and that black fountain. That is never going to happen. Because they're insane if they really think that that will happen in 2017. You're insane if you think that one. Excuse me. Guys and girls, things like this have to stop. And if these things could continue to go on, and Caucasians like Miss Kelly, because I'm going to play that video, like Miss Kelly talking to D.L. Hughley like he was totally dumb, and told D.L. Hughley, you don't wow me. He put her ass in her place. Like I say, they really think that we are their kids. They wasn't even born in the 60s. Most Caucasians were born in the 60s, and they still think that they are going to put African Americans in their place, like we supposed to bow down and say, yes, master, you're right. You're insane if you assume that. She said, don't wow me. Who are you? Oh, my God. I have to get this video up. But I know my computer right now is acting up, and I'm trying to analyze it, get it analyzed, so it can start working in a better way. I always have a problem with this computer. Might have to give me another one. But, yeah, when she said that, I was like, wow, this is a grown-ass man. You gonna tell him, don't wow me, like, he's a child. And he did put her in a place. You gonna tell me what I should do? And she was saying, like, it's no racism. It's amazing how many Caucasians is under this rock and really thinking there is no racism. Why? Because everything benefits you. So you wouldn't see it as racism, because you don't have to get stopped by cops and get shot down in the middle of the street. And let me tell you something. Don't sit up there and tell me that you guys are not abiding by the law. Excuse me? Fidel Castro was reaching for his wallet, and he told the cop, I have a gun behind me. If he wanted to shoot the cop, he would have shot that cop. But he warned the guy. He said, don't shoot me. I have a gun behind me. I'm going to get my license, my permit. And the guy shot him anyway. Not only that, his excuse is the reason why it wasn't no broken taillight. He lied. It was because Philando Castle nose was wide. Come on, people. Have you been pulled over, Caucasians? Because of your nose being wide or being long? No, you have not. So don't come to me and tell me that the reason why he got shot is because he didn't obey the cops. The cop. Don't tell me that. Just like Alton Sterling, you want to bring up his past record. What that got to do with now? What happened to him now? He didn't do anything. He was minding his own business. They brought another excuse talking about somebody said that he had a gun. Nobody didn't say a damn thing. You went over there. Your cops went over there. And you saw a black man try to make a living and you don't like it. Simple as that. That's what it boils down to. You didn't like a black man that actually was trying to make a living. But you could constantly sit up there and say, black men don't take care of their kids. But you constantly continue to try to take money away from them so they can take care of the kids. Or black men are not there in the household. But you continue to shoot down these black men that no longer can be in the household. But we already know the statistics. The statistics show that the better fathers are African American men. It's not you Caucasians. You're doctors and lawyers. You'll leave your practice and not take care of your kids. I know that one. Saw that one. Let's I want to get to this thing with D.L. Hughley. Meg, I want you to hear this. He put her in her place. I love that. He put her in that place, baby. I'm gonna get this video up because I want you guys to hear that. And try to get this up right here, because when I just couldn't believe she had some nerves, had the nerves to shush him, and had the nerves to tell him, you don't wow me. Where is this at? Okay. Couldn't believe that they actually said, and Fox, I'm so not surprised with Fox, not at all, that they're saying that racism doesn't exist. I have never seen a news channel that more racist than anything. When it comes out there, I'm like, I don't even know what to say. I just shake my head and like, okay. And I'm like, wow. But anyone who out here would think that racism doesn't exist, it's because you have your white privilege. And you just don't know and don't care. Because it hasn't happened to you. And you have no concerns about it. But it kills me when they try to make an excuse for these cops when they kill African Americans. They really try to make an excuse. Like, it's okay, well, because they killing each other, so it's okay, the cops. That's why cops are not getting indicted. They're not getting indicted at all. They're killing a lot of innocent African Americans that have not done anything. They're killing, they have, it's just amazing. They have, you Caucasians have more compassion for a dog or a cat or anything else than you have for us as a people. And we're basically like, you're going to keep on shooting us down? How long you think that's going to last? Just like your ancestors fought the British in 1776? How long you think it's going to last with us? It have been lasting for a long time. You got to be insane if you think it's going to last any longer. You got to be insane if you think that it will last. You insane, period. That's why I wanted to talk about this situation, is because just to see the reactions of Caucasians and saying that it's no racism exists, because that's not the only one that I ever heard on the news channel and anything else, anybody else, that they're in the dark and saying that racism doesn't exist. You got to be kidding. It's only because it's not affecting you. You don't have to walk out the door every day and hear somebody call you a nigga. You don't have to walk out here and say you're a lazy black person. First of all, I don't like the word black and white. I don't like that, because that's not inheritative. That's not where I'm from. That's a color. So when they sit up there and say, oh, you guys kill each other? Why you want to address that first? We're addressing that, but we're addressing the cop killing as well. You're not going to get an excuse. You crazy? You insane? You're trying to make an excuse. So it's okay. Just like when, I just can't believe this cop actually said, well, I'm pulling him over because he have a broad nose. Oh, you saw an African-American male in there. This is the question I want to ask. The crazy question. My question is, so you Caucasian men think, because it boils back all the way back to slavery. So you think if you kill all the African-American men, do you think that you're going to start by sleeping with the African-American women, raping them? You know, we carry guns too. Legal guns. So you'll be goddamn insane if you think that we're going to go back, you Caucasian men, start raping African-American women. This is why I tell my people.
Joining me now with reaction, D.L. Hughley, actor, radio host, and author of Black Man, White House, an oral history of the Obama years. DL, thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me. I didn't know Mark Furman was going to be here.
What did you make? Because you're shaking your head.
I think that cops will have a different perspective than us, and I think it was interesting to hear Mark Furman, who was actually got in trouble for perjuring himself, calling somebody a liar. It's ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. But what do you make of the fact that she had inconsistencies in her story?
I think the cop had inconsistencies in his too. Mm-hmm. To me.
So then you let the evidence play out.
Here's my problem. No matter, it is my belief that no matter what happens, no matter what we see, the cops are given a presumption of innocence. If that same tape showed a suspect doing something, that would be all the prosecution would need. They would say the evidence is all right here. But a cop gets a presumption of innocence that is, no matter what they see, we can see somebody getting shot to death. They go, we don't know what happened before. We don't know what happened after. Mm-hmm. I know this, that in a state, in both these states, men, a lot of men in Louisiana, 47% of people carry guns. Men carry guns. So men having guns on them can't be that unusual. Why wasn't the first question, rather than assuming, do you have a permit for that? Mm-hmm. Those are states that you can carry a gun.
But you're making assumptions because we don't know what happened.
No.
What we have right now is her testimonial, which doesn't capture the actual event. Do we know whether she's credible? Do we know whether...
We know this. We know he had a permit to carry a gun.
But that doesn't answer any of the questions.
That absolutely answers the question.
If he pulled the firearm on the officer, if he didn't disclose it, if the officer felt threatened...
Why on earth would you... Here's what we do know. He had a permit to carry a gun. When you get a permit to carry a gun, they tell you exactly how to act when a police officer...
That doesn't mean he didn't threaten the officer.
You're willing to give them a presumption of innocence.
I'm not giving them presumption. Well, the law gives them the presumption of innocence.
No, they're bad.
I'm saying we don't know the facts.
I mean,
we saw this happen with Michael Brown of Ferguson.
And we still don't know the facts there. We have a police officer's word and a grand jury's word.
No, we have the Department of Justice's word.
The Department of Justice shut down Ferguson. Ferguson had to be shut down because it was so corrupt.
The Department of Justice found that the police there had endemic racism. They found that.
Right.
But they also exonerated Officer Gary Wilson.
That's not a...
And they found Hands Up, Don't Shoot was a lie.
Let me ask you something.
And that Michael Brown was the aggressor.
Wow. Here's what I'll say.
Don't wow me.
Don't tell me not to wow you. I can say wow if I want to, and I'll tell you this.
That is what they found,
I'll tell you this. They found systemic racism, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's unbelievable. They also found systemic racism, and we know that Darren Wilson left the department because it was so racist it had to be disbanded, and with the Ferguson, another department that is rife with racism.
So that makes him a racist.
Absolutely. You know, I have no problem.
Michael Brown
grabbed
that officer's gun and tried to shoot him in his patrol car.
That is, no one has proven that.
That's what Eric Holder's DOJ concluded.
That the department was so rife with
corruption. I already conceded that, DL. Talking about Michael Brown and the lie of Hands Up, Don't Shoot.
I don't dodge at all. I'm here in Fox News.
Michael Brown.
We were talking about the young man that just got murdered in Minnesota.
First off,
what I'll tell you is this. It is not uncommon for you all to see one thing. The only place racism doesn't exist is Fox News and the police department.
That's absolutely insulting. You just insulted millions of people watching this channel.
And you know what? I'm insulted by the things I hear on this network, so we're even. I could care less about insulting people that insult me on a daily basis.
You're making a point that is, before the insults, the point you started to make is true. And we can talk about that whites perceive the situation when it comes to these
I think a lot
Let
of people on this network
Let me just
never
finish,
seen a black man anything deserved.
Could you hold the insults for a second so we can have a productive conversation? You were going to make the points that whites see certain incidents differently than blacks do. And we saw that in the O.J. Simpson case when the verdict came down.
Sure.
I'll give you that. Most reasonable people will give you that. But you know what shuts down all reasonable dialogue is throwing out the term racism before it's been proven.
You know what's, first off, I'll say this. I believe that there is a benefit of the doubt given to police officers that's not given to anybody else. And maybe, obviously they do a tough job. You can't. In 2006, the FBI came out with a report that said that police departments were rife with white supremacists. Said it, not me. So why would I believe, if I know that? I don't know a black man that hasn't had a run-in with a police officer, mm-hmm. from the highest to the lowest.
My perception of this is
based on the experience I've had, just like yours are.
Mm-hmm.
So I am not willing to give them a benefit of that. I have seen a lot of things. I lived in the city that Mark Fermor policed that also had to be taken over by the federal government.
It's very dangerous when you get to the point where you paint with an entire group with the same brush based on the bad actions of a few.
That is amazing to hear on this network. That really is.
DL.
That really is. Amazing to hear on this network. The only place where
Thanks for being here.
Thank you for
Take
having
care.
Me.
Take care.
Yeah, she thought he was going to back down. Man, come on now. Get your life. You really thought that and talking about racism doesn't exist and we shouldn't call out racism when we don't know what happened? Come on! Then all these African-American people are killing themselves by the hands of the cops? Are they killing themselves? It's amazing how Fox thinks. Well, they have also, I want to play another video. The NYPD cop allegedly record shows that the supervisor pursued African-American black men, African-Americans, they pursue them. And it's on audio tape. Interesting. But there's no racism. There is no racism. People, wake up. Really? If you think there's no racism, wake up. This is what I'm saying. Wake up. There's racism everywhere. And it's not only just in America, but we need to tend to American problems instead of trying to tend to anybody else's problem. But it was a leak, auto tape leak. One of the supervisor pressured.
Who commits the crimes? Who commits the crimes? There's mostly teenagers, anywhere between the ages of 15 and 19, mostly male, black, and Hispanics.
Okay. Who are you stopping?
Everybody. I stop everybody.
54 tabs up to 820.
Mm-hmm.
25 was a female. Half.
Okay. Like I said, I stop everybody. I'm not targeting anybody, first of all.
You just told me who the bad guys are.
Yeah, I know that. But also, there's also other people who are committing violations as well. I'm not saying that there's not violations being made.
Male blacks that you commit the crime.
Plenty of people that I write sentences to are male blacks and male Hispanics.
Male blacks.
Not for the whole year. And I have... You're telling me for the whole year, I only saw two male blacks for some
820.
No.
January 1st, August 20th. 54 tags, two male blacks, seven Hispanics, seven other, 10 whites, three Asians. So where are you targeting the perp that you just told me?
Well, like I said, if I don't see a perp jumping over the turnstile, what am I supposed to do to him? That's what I'm saying.
These people have to pop.
How do I know that? I have a 100%
chance.
A female Hispanic that I thought that she said they did pop actually for a warrant and I arrested her. Female Hispanic. The Hispanics that were supposed to be going up that are committing the crimes. The people that I.
Do you think that she's going to pop?
Did I think she was going to pop? I didn't put no thought into it. If you come up and you're getting. And you'll come up with a collar, I'm taking you in.
This is what I see. You described to me who's committing the crimes and you're fully aware of it. You're not talking to those people.
I'm talking to everybody.
Two male blacks.
Whoever's out there. If I catch...
So you only saw two male blacks jumping the turnstile?
If you're saying that's what's in front of you, then yes, that's all I saw. There's two male blacks the whole year jumping the turnstile. That's what you're saying is in front of you. I'm not disputing that. You're saying that's what I got there?
That's Jim. That is not disputing here.
Well, I'm saying, but we also talking Hispanics as well. I stopped a lot of Hispanics too.
Seven male Hispanics, but more than half of females.
And like I said, everybody's committing violations in front of me.
Did you hear that? The supervisor wanted this police officer to pursue more African-Americans than Caucasian. That on his list, he pursued whoever he wanted to pursue. He pursued everyone. It was equal. And that's what he kept on telling his supervisor. Listen, I'm going to get whoever. Whoever is equal is not going to be separate. I'm going to pursue whomever. And the supervisor pulled out and said it's 10 Caucasians that was fined and had warrants. It says the officer didn't like that. He said, so you only pull over one Hispanic woman and two African Americans, but you have 10 Caucasians that had warrants and everything. And he said, yes. He said, I got whoever. I'm not discriminating against anybody. I find whoever, this is who I'm pulling over. Well, the supervisor had a problem with that. The supervisor wanting him to pull over more African-American people than Caucasians. That these Caucasians came back, these 10 Caucasians came back with warrants and arrests. That's how they are. They'll look at Caucasians. You look at us so quick into a store. May I help you? No, I didn't ask you for your help. When I asked you for your help, then we could talk. But why you looking so hard at me? You have like 3 and 4 Caucasians walking out that store stealing. Why? Because they know that you're going to look at that one African-American. You're going to follow that one African-American around. That guess what? We have money. You know how many plenty times I walked to a store, Dillard's or anything like that, was going to purchase Chanel for my girlfriend when I had one, and different, a nice, because I like, and I like watches, I like G-Shocks, I like Invictors, I like that. Walk in store, I have money, I work hard for my money. Walk in a store, look at, oh, look at this, just looking around, I have somebody, may I help you, follow me around, go to her, say, no, you cannot. When I ask you for help, please be there. So I go upstairs looking for a belt. I buy me belts and Dillard's, all kinds of store. Any store that have decent product and nice products. So Lord & Taylor, all these places. I'm not going to keep on naming their name out because they're not going to pay me anyway. So I go to these places. And they follow me around, and I got tired, and I turned around. I said, may I help you? And we were just seeing if you need anything. I say, yeah. See, let me show me that watch. I see a nice G-Shock. Look at the G-Shock. Show me that Invictor. Show me that Diesel. You know, that's what I said. So they show it to me on the case. I say, no, I want to look at it. So they bring it up, and I said, okay, I'll purchase this. And I have done this. And they go, and they look at me strange. It might cost about $400 or $500 or something like that. And they ring it up on my credit card, and they look at it, and they saw it go through. Then I say, you know what? I decide, I don't want that. I don't want that watch. Let me go ahead and look at another watch. No, you know what? I want my refund. And walk my ass right away. You won't get no money from me. Get my refund. And they look, they stand there and say, you sure you don't want it? No. While you're following me, you don't know how much money I have. So at the end of the day, this is what you won't get commission off me. You won't. And I tell them that. I will tell them that. What, they going to say they ain't going to refund me? And I'm standing there and I just purchased that? Child, please, refund me. I won't play with you, Caucasians. I barely go in your stores now because if I want anything to eat, I go to the international store and I go there and buy my food. I do not, I don't care. I'm going to tell you that, nah. I'm not going to supply you. I'm not going to help you. If you're going to treat me like I'm nothing, and I know I work hard, I work my butt off. Sure won't. Nope. Will not support you. Trust me, I will not support you. You think you could take our money, but at the end of the day, and behind my back, you're going to call me a nigga. I'm a lazy one, but you still trying to take my money. Come on now. Where they do that at? Are you serious? Make an excuse for a lot of cops that's killing my people. You make an excuse there. You stand and you don't do nothing, you Caucasians, that means you're with the white supremacists. You're with them. So stand away from me. Here go another video that I was watching. D.L. Hughley was speaking to the former mayor in NYC, Rudy Gun Gonzalez, or whatever his damn name is. I don't care about pronouncing his name anyways. He's the most racist one of all. And and D.L. Hughley go off on him as well. But I could care less about Rudy. I could care less. That's why I don't want to pronounce his name right. I know how to pronounce his name. You know, I'm not good with names anyway, but I know how to pronounce his name. But I don't want to pronounce his name. He was the most racist mayor that it is. They target more African-Americans than anything under his reign. And they love saying, oh, he was the best mayor there is. I bet you was, because he didn't have to come and get you guys. He was messing with us, his racist ass. That's why the Italians, they people of color, and they still think they better than African Americans. I swear. And we'll call you a muck real quick. You're a freaking African American. You're a person of color. Listen.
There is a danger in false parity. You're right. There's statistics going around now that, hey, did you know that more whites get shot by cops than blacks?
You know why?
You don't adjust for population, and there are a lot of other factors that go into it as well. In fact, I had one guy, I've been researching this like crazy, because I'm trying to understand how I can be of value here. It can't stay this way. Cool. And I had a social scientist say to me, hey, you know, this idea that blacks resist more than whites, he's like, you know, to put my hand on it, I don't think that's even true, because blacks have such an odd disposition when it comes to police. They feel that they have to acquiesce in a way a lot of whites don't. They feel they can have conversations and pressure.
Yes, more white people get shot by police than black people. About 120 more.
Right.
But there are 120 million more white people.
That's right.
If you adjusted it for
sure. percentage, what's not even close.
We are five times more likely to be shot.
Five times more likely.
You know what happens? That racism and bigotry have great PR. They have great PR. People store out statistics like that that they know aren't true, but people will believe it because they want to. The fact is that black people are five times more likely to be shot than white people. Black on black crime. More white people commit crime than black people. It is true. Even if you adjust it for population, more white people commit crime than black people. But when you say black on black crime, that gives you the incentive to go out there and do something about it. It gives you a call to action. Now we have an immediate situation that has to be dealt with. And when we repeat those things, it gives it breath.
You also have a situation where what happens in the immediate sense, often context gets lost to it. Why do you have more blacks coming into contact with police where it turns violent? So you start looking at the numbers. Well, where are these police? Well, what's going on in those neighborhoods? Now, you can stop your analysis right there and say, they're high crime, poor black areas. Feel for the police. They have to do the job. But why are they high crime areas? Where is the education? Right. Where is the opportunity? This is complex. And I often feel that the reason that people don't have an open mind is we don't want to go there. We don't want to go to the Absolutely. Real reasons. Let's just end it with this one guy and this one cop and leave the analysis. But do you think that's the right way to do it?
Obviously, it hasn't served them well. Like, if you look at Tamir Rice was a 13-year-old kid playing with a toy gun. Right?
Yeah.
The police officer that shot him was employed by the Independence Police Department and fired because he was out of the academy. He was such a bad police officer, they thought that no amount of training would ever make him a reasonable officer.
Mm-hmm.
Then they put that very officer 9 months later in Cleveland, and he killed someone. And society, and we all know this happened, and he's let off, and it's not his fault. You cannot tell me all lives matter when some are treated distinctly different. I can mourn for police officers that are slain, and I can mourn for two young black men that were slain. I don't have a moral dilemma in it.
I think that all lives matter is a perversion of what makes black lives matter special.
Sure.
There is an obvious inequity. Everybody knows that. The reasons for it need to be debated. Sure. How you fix it needs to be prayed for.
Sure.
But there's an obvious parity. My question to you is, I want to leave with us on this. One, I want your promise to continue this conversation. Two, I want you to give me your best sense of how can we get better from where we are?
It is a simple, you know, everybody asks that question. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. I watched the movie A Time to Kill, and at the end of it, he made this great analysis, and he said if she were white, he made the equivalent to her being white. People are treated differently. Biases, police officers have fears and biases. There's no doubt about that. And they're based on any number of things. But if your fears and biases get me killed, and my anger and frustration get you killed, we're going to act human. We are no less or more human. Every time you turn around, somebody is making a moral reason why somebody's slain in the streets. And it's an abhorrent behavior. And it would be abhorrent if I see a young black man slaughter five police officers, or whether you see police officers slay five black men. When Rudy Giuliani says that black lives matter are terrorists, black lives matter, let me tell you something. I don't think all black people are all anything or all white people are all anything. But to be castigated with the same brush that they did Michael Johnson would be a quick equivalent to me telling you that all white people think like Dylan Roof. Mm-hmm. And that would be deeply offensive. And to allow somebody to say that on air and to go unchallenged saying that on air, because a lot of people...
Not here.
No. A lot of people want that narrative because it edifies their perspective.
Well, when it comes from someone like Rudy Giuliani, do you think that, and I've been watching the Twitter war, people can go online and see for themselves.
Sure.
But do you think that he was trying to make a more innocuous point? That he was trying to say, love of humanity?
I think that there was nothing loving about that situation. I think he was a brutal mayor who had basically a reign of terror of black people in this country and in the city. To me, taking parenting advice from Rudy Giuliani is like Kim Kardashian giving me marriage advice. It is ridiculous. It is ridiculous when you have a person who has set over some of the most heinous things that happened to black people in the history of this country, and to say something like that every time somebody says something about injustice, they are the terrorists. MLK would be considered a terrorist. Gandhi was a terrorist. Mandela was a terrorist. And all they were trying to do was fight for legal, for justice. Mm. And to me, to have when old white men tell black men how to act, like that's the most ridiculous thing in the world. Like, he'll tell you how to tell black people to speak a certain way and act a certain way is no different than telling a woman how to dress so she doesn't get raped.
Bush said yesterday, we need to remember our loyalty to humanity.
Sure.
Obama said, we have to have the character to find unity.
Sure.
Dale Hughley, I feel you're doing both of those things.
Right.
Thank you for being here to continue the conversation.
Well, indeed. Thank you.
Okay, just let there's nothing to be said. What he said was the truth. It was and when that mayor was in New York, he was terrible. He went after African American people, but somehow people sit up here and say there's no racism. How dare you say it's racism? How could you say it's racism? So if you want to live under that rock that you're living under and believe that there is no racism around here, then so be it. Live under that rock. But don't expect us to sit up here and allow these things to keep on occurring to our brothers and sisters and think we're just going to sit on our butts and allow you guys to kill us. This is a modern day lynching. And I tell my people, I'm directing this to my people. Let's boycott Target. Let's boycott Walmart. Let's boycott all the stores that support these white supremacists. We spend trillions and trillions of dollars each year. Let's boycott these places. Stop going to buy Jordans. Stop doing these things, people. Let's boycott these places. Let's boycott Hooters. Let's boycott all the places that you go to. Come on. Wake up. Because the only way they're going to hear us by all this talking, I'm tired of talking. I'm tired of talking, people. I don't want to hear talking anymore. I want to hear you doing some action. Hell, they was talking so much, they put it in the Constitution. Guess what? We still got to go through the same crap. So let's not sit up here and listen to all this talking. I am so out of this. I am so done with the talking. I'm going to tell you, I am so done with the talking. Done with the talking. I am done with the talking. I'm telling you, I don't want to hear nothing about talking anymore. You either get your butt, do what you need to do, or just I don't want to hear it. I just don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. I do not want to hear it. I swear I don't. Everybody continue to talk. Everybody continue to listen. I just... I'm so much at the point that people I'm at a point that I have had enough of the bullshit. That's basically what I am. I'm at that point. What more can I say? I don't even know what to say anymore. I'm just like, I don't know what you guys expect from us, but if you think that we're just going to sit here and tolerate the things that you're doing to us, you're so sadly mistaken. So sadly mistaken. People, my people, wake up. It is not a game, because they are actually killing our people left and right. And they're saying, like, it's no racism. Because they don't have to live in it. They don't have to live in it at all. They don't have to worry about that. At all. It's a mind game. And it's something that if you think it's just going to keep on happening, I'm telling you, white people, if you think it's just something that's going to keep on happening, I'm just right here, I'm just like, it's not going to keep happening. It's not. It's got to stop. It's got to stop. I mean, I'm so frustrated right now that for people who do not have to live these lives, my life, and say there is no racism, because I have been pulled up. I just gave you a fine example about about my life. Just walking in a nice shopping for myself, and I got pulled over several times. It was a white woman in front of me, a Caucasian in front of me, speeding. This Caucasian cop, he didn't see her, but he saw me. And I was so far away from her. She was speeding. I told him, when he pulled me up, I said, why would you pull me over when a Caucasian right in front of me was speeding her ass off? But you were pulling me over. Why? Because I was driving with being black? He looked at me and he said, have a good day. Because he already knew what was up. He just thought that I was going to be stupid. But ladies and gentlemen, it's time for me to go. Let's boycott. Let's come together. Let's unite and get it together. Because this is the only way we're going to hurt them is by their money. Hurt them by their money and laws. People, come and join me. I have a program that I have started up already. LLC, the Rebirth, the New Trend. This is a new program to start up. It's getting these people by their own laws. These people, I mean, are Caucasians, cops, use their own laws against them, because they are volatile people. You cannot use violence towards them. They believe in violence. So come join me, the Rebirth and New Trend. You can get in touch with me. Just hit me up. Just type in the Rebirth and New Trend. It will come up. Just type and hit me up. Everybody, good day.
Come on, let's face it. I get our education's basic, and most of the youth them waste it. And when them waste it, that's when them take the guns, replace it. Then them don't stand a chance at all. And that's why enough little youth have
up some fatmatic with the extra magazine in a them back pocket. And a fleet at night time in a some black jacket. All who now lock Glock said them a lock rocket. Them a fully woke back up run like a shock socket. Them a run a road block which for the cops block it. And from now till a morning no stop clock it. If them run out of rounds I broke back rocket. Subside, north side.